Student. In this video, we are going to see the topic under for the model 2, differential equation of higher order. So as we have seen already for two videos in this topic, the first one we have started with the differential equations, then we have seen with the definition of homogeneous and non-homogeneous, and we learned how to solve for the homogeneous equations, right? In the homogeneous, we'll continue in the part of your non-homogeneous also, because it is supposed to be solved by both your left side and right side. Okay, so now you can see with the last video, which is nothing but the right side, the non-homogeneous equation, the particular integral, how we can able to find a solution when you have a function of x is in terms of exponential format, that means e power ax. So right, so in e power ax means what we have done, we are supposed to replace by d is equal to a, and we are trying to get your solution of your particular integral. Suppose the denominator will go 0, what you have to do? We are supposed to multiply with independent variable to the numerator and take a differentiation to the denominator, right? Then again we need to replace your d is equal to a to get your particular integral. Okay, so in this video we are going to see your next type, that is nothing but type 2, when you have a trigonometry functions. Okay, so your f of x in terms of sin x or cos x, only these two have been defined, it sin x or cos x format. So how we can go? So you have an f of x either as a sin x or cos x, your particular integral is equal to 1 by f of d squared of sin ax by cos ax. It is f of d squared is nothing but you are supposed to be replaced only with a d squared. Okay, you have in function of d, it may be d cube or d squared or only d, it can be a possible. Okay, so what you are going to do, first step, you are supposed to replace the places of d squared. So only the places of d squared to be replaced by minus a squared. So a is taken from the coefficient of your x in trigonometry term of sine or cos term. Okay, so you are supposed to replace d squared places equal to minus a squared. So remember, it is not a minus a the whole square, it is minus a squared. So d squared places you are supposed to be replaced by minus a squared. That is possible only your f of minus a squared is not equal to 0. Same condition. If it is equal to 0, what we have done in first type, similar method we are going to do here. So what you have to do, multiply with x to the numerator, take a differentiation of a denominator, again you are going to replace d squared is equal to minus a squared. Again you check whether it is not equal to 0. Then you can proceed with the solution. Otherwise, what you have to do? Again, you can multiply with x and take a differentiation. How it will convert? It is x squared in the numerator. And denominator will be f double dash of d squared. Then again, d squared to be replaced by minus a squared. It's clear? So it's to be replaced only with the term of, what is that? D squared. You're not supposed to replace by d. Okay, then we'll go with one example problem to understand this particular integral type. Okay, that is nothing but your type 2 problem. So let me see with the example, what is that? D square plus 4 of y is equal to sine 3x, isn't it? So what will be a first step? It is a non-homogeneous equation. Then first you have to solve in your left side, right? So m square plus 4 equal to 0, by replacing d is equal to m, it will be converted differential equations to the algebraic format by replacing d is equal to m. So this equation is called, what is the name? It is called as an auxiliary equation, isn't it? So m square plus 4 equal to 0, that implies you can write it m is equal to minus 4. So m squared equal to minus 4. So m will be plus or minus 2i, isn't it? Square root of minus 4. So 4 will be 2 squared, minus 1 will be, you can write it I squared. So it will become a plus or minus 2i. So it will go for which case? It will be in your third case, isn't it? Alpha plus or minus I beta. So alpha value is 0, beta value is 2. So you can write your complementary function c1 cos 2x plus c2 sin 2x. So now you can go for your particular integral. What is your particular integral? 1 by d square plus 4. So whatever is our exact equation, you write here d square plus 4 into sine 3x. So that is your right side equation. It is sine 3x. What is your a value here? A is equal to 3 because the general format says it is sine ax, isn't it? So a is equal to 3. So you can get sine 3x is nothing but you are supposed to replace the places of d square to be minus a square. So how it will change? Minus 3 square will become minus 9 plus 4. So it will become minus 5. So sine 3x by minus 5. So this is your particular integral. Now you can go with a solution. Y is equal to c1 cos 2x plus c2 sine 2x minus sine 3x by 5. So you don't forget to write a complete solution with the complementary function plus particular integral. Okay, so this is your complete solution of your given question, right? So we'll go with a one more problem. Like what is that? D square plus 3d plus 2 into y is equal to cos 2x, right? So first step, solve in your left side by using your what is it? The complementary function you need to find. By replacing d is equal to m, I will get m squared plus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0. That is m is equal to minus 1 comma minus 2. In like this kind of problem, you can choose in your calculator because desiring both complementary function and particular integral. So you can write it directly. The question is asked only for the complementary function. That means homogeneous equation, that time you have to show your factorization, otherwise you can skip, right? So what is your yc, the complementary function, it will go which case? It is a which case? It will be a first case, right? So real and distinct. So you have a complementary function as c1 e power minus x plus c2 e power minus 2x. Now go with your right side. What is that term? I have a particular integral cos 2x by d square plus 3d plus 2. Okay, now you can replace only the places of d square. D you can't able to replace, right? So in that cases, what to be replaced? A value is 2, isn't it? So you can replace 2 squared, it is a minus 4 plus 3d plus 2. Clear na? D square to be replaced by minus a squared, it is a minus 4. Now this minus 4 plus 2 will become minus 2, right? So how it will be denominator? Cos 2x by 3d, see here 3d, then minus 2 I will get. So what I have as per the type 2, I am supposed to replace only with d square term. So I can't able to replace by d term. To make a d squared, I need to multiply with the d term, right? So just like that, you can't able to multiply for the differential operator. For that reason, I'm going to take the conjugate of this denominator. So it is a 3d minus 2. So conjugate will be 3d plus 2 by 3d plus 2. Multiply and divide by the conjugate of your denominator. So what will happen in the numerator? 3d plus 2 into cos of 2x, isn't it? And denominator will become a minus b into a plus b. So it is a square minus b square. So denominator will be 9d squared. Then minus of 2 squared will be minus 4. But you see in the numerator how it has come this step. I'll explain. See here. You have an 3d into cos 2x, right? So what is mean by d? D is nothing but d by dx, right? So it will become 3 into d by dx of cos 2x. So how it will change? Cos 2x differentiation will give sine 2x into, you have a term, so differentiation of cos will be minus sine, right? So minus sine 2x into 2x will become 2. So that's what is written, 3 into minus 2 into sine 2x, right? Plus again 2 you can multiply. I have a 2 into cos 2x. So that's all for the numerator. I think it's clear now. Now denominator will become 3. It is a 9 d squared, then minus 4. Again d squared has come. So d squared supposed to be replaced by what is that? Minus a square. It is a minus 2 squared will become 9 into minus 4 minus 4. So now you can simplify. It will become minus 3 sine 2x plus cos 2x by 20, isn't it? So you have the term of minus terms will have. So it will have a minus 20. So now what is that? You have 3 sine 2x by 20 minus 1 by 20 into cos 2x, right? So that's all for your solutions of your particular integral we found it. So complete solution, you can write it by what is that? Complementary function plus particular integral will give your complete solutions. Okay. So one more assignments has been given. It's not like an assignment. You just practice in home and try to get the answer. Answer also has been mentioned and it is a very familiar problem for both. You try to get it. Okay. So first one, directly you replace d squared b minus 1. The second one is a little different. What is it? You have a cos squared x. So cos squared x and sin squared x, whenever you have, convert in terms of cos. That means 1 plus cos 2x by 2 and the sin square will be 1 minus cos 2x by 2. No, that formula you can use it and you can apply for two particular integral and apply separately with f of d square format. Okay. So try to get this answer. You check it. Okay. Thank you.